Ever feel like your robot's movements could make or break your FLL season? What if I told you there's a secret weapon? These three simple MyBlocks that can instantly make your robot faster, more accurate, and ready to crush any mission. These aren't just any MyBlocks. They helped me win the National ARL Championship, and they'll do the same for you. Let's get straight into it. This will be the last video in my Spike Prime Block Programming tutorial series. But before we dive in, I've got something to share. Balancing school and creating content like this can be tough, but I love helping the FLL community. That's why I've set up a Discord server packed with helpful resources. And I'm personally there to help you tackle any challenges, whether it's programming, building, or just needing advice. I'm also gonna put extra more advanced MyBlocks there. I've got you covered. The link is in the description. Come say hi. So first up is the MyBlock for moving straight and backwards using the distance input. This one's a game changer because instead of constantly tweaking your code, you just plug in the distance and direction and the robot does the rest. Forward, backward, no problem. This is gonna be similar to my gyro straight one, except with a little bit more inputs and a little bit more complex. Let me show you how it works.
All right, let me walk you through this code step by step. So first we define the move straight block, which tells the robot to move forward or backwards a specific distance at a certain speed. And at the start, we reset the gyro sensor to zero. We set one motor rotation to the dimensions of our wheels. This is specifically the circumference in centimeters. Then we set our movement motors, and then we set the movement acceleration to whatever, and then we set the motors to brake at a stop. This I find is more accurate when going a specific distance. Then we use the waypoint 1 second. I just use this for debugging purposes. And then if the direction is forward, the code calculates how many wheel rotations are needed to cover the specific distance. The robot starts moving and keeps checking its yaw angle to stay straight. If it drifts, the code applies the correction to bring it back on track. Then here's for backwards movement. If the direction is backwards, it works the same way but in reverse or in the negative. It calculates the distance, moves backwards, and uses the gyro sensor to correct any drift. Here, you can see that. Finally, once the robot reaches the target distance, it stops moving completely. So, in short, this program moves the robot forward or backwards while keeping it straight, thanks to the gyro sensor constantly correcting its direction. Pretty cool, right? Now, let's see it in action.
So I'm gonna test it going backwards 1 foot and then forwards 1 foot. The approximate conversion of this in centimeters is 30.5, which is what I have it set at right now. I don't have a measuring tape in centimeters, so that's why. So, and let me take the camera with me. So here you can see that the base of the wheel is at the end of the measuring tape. So it should work out fine. So let's see this. So as you can see, it kept the straight path and the measuring tape is at the same spot. So yeah, pretty accurate.
See, clean, consistent, and ready for competition.
Hey everyone, so while editing this video, I realized it was getting way too long and I didn't want to take up too much of your time. That's why I decided to break it down into three shorter, more focused videos that'll be all in one playlist. That way you can get all the info you need without sitting through one long video. If you're excited to dive into these MyBlocks and how they can level up your robotics game, make sure to hit that like button. Let's aim for 50 likes on this video. If we hit that goal, I'll create a bonus video sharing some of my personal tips for optimizing your robot's performance this season. And don't forget to leave a comment below. Which MyBlocks are you most excited to learn about? Or if you have any questions, just let me know in the Discord or in the comments below. Your feedback helps shape the content I create. Lastly, if you're new here, be sure to subscribe and turn on the notifications so you don't miss the rest of the series. Let's learn and grow together. See you in the next video.